What's up, guys? This is your boy, it's Jairo, and it is hot out here in Austin, Texas. 108 degrees today, so be sure to stay out of the heat, guys. And if you guys are out there, be sure to stay hydrated. But anyways, I'm going to do a few shout-outs real quick. Go check out 360 Sound Drop and Red Eyed Pictures. We are going to be playing Team Fortress 2 today on PC. Using Fraps, test it out a little bit better, see how it does for a commentary, gameplay, so on, so on, so. But anyways, I'll be playing as the Pyro and the Soldier. We're playing Capture the Flag on 2Flag. And I joined this game and then just started up Fraps, and then we like end the round by winning. But it's 0-0 right now, and we end up like winning the game, so. Anyways, we're going to talk about the Battlefield 3 Alpha Trial. I did get to play it, guys, from Persian Glory HD. He gave me his code because I did the requirements for the video that he had for the giveaway. So he gave it to me, and I got to play it for 2 days. So I thought I would share pretty much everything that I saw from the game whenever I played and tell you guys about it so you guys know what to look forward to. Or what might or might not be changed, you know, like who knows. But like anyways, it was over on Monday. I got my code on like Saturday or Friday. The map was Operation Metro, and it was up to 32 people, so it was 16 versus 16 at the most. The game type was Rush, and I never saw past the third like MCOM area. I only got to the third part one time. Other than that, each of the attacking teams were usually stopped within the first 2 second like MCOM like areas. So the map was kind of bad for a rush, and I think they need to set up some of the spawning better and so on so on. But it's alpha, and it was all just for testing. In reality, I thought it was fun, but I would have liked to see what the fourth area look like, so. But the tank you could use, and the tank was the like LAV, and it's a like amphibious tank that can hold up to 6 people, and all 6 people have a weapon to use. Now, there's a guy that's driving the tank and in control of the main turret, and then there's a guy in the secondary turret that has like a giant like me, a giant like machine gun that can turn full 360, and then the other 4 people inside of the like LAV will sit in the side of it and shoot from the side, kind of how these small tanks are in Battlefield Bad Company 2. So 6 guns on that thing, and the thing is overpowered like a motherfucker, because I jumped up in one the very first time I ever got to drive one, went on 14 kills, and after 6 RPGs they finally killed me. So, I mean, 6. But, the classes that I played and all, of course, it was the recon first, because I had to check out how the sniping was. You start off with semi-auto, like, snipers to begin with on both sides, and each of the factions, kind of how the game, like, Medal of Honor was, wherever the one side would have one type of weapons and then the other side would have a different type of weapons. Well, it's the same thing. It's like the one like recons on the like US, they get a M11, and then the Russians, they get the SVD to start off with, and then you unlock the SV98 that can be used by like either side in the like alpha trials. So the assault was either you get the AK-47M or the M16, then there was the engineer class and the support class. I really didn't play all that much of those. I was actually trying to like unlock stuff with the recon class. But the SV-98 is pretty nice. I would say that what would you say the scope on the weapons itself, they seem a little bit small, like the like aim like reticules for them, but they might fix that or might not. I don't know, it just seems a little bit small per se for how big the map was. and along with being able to be prone now, is actually quite good feature. I mean, a lot of people thought, you know, well, now people are just going to be camping hardcore, and they do camp hardcore, but if you have a sniper rifle to counteract their prone little ass, then you can usually take them out. I mean, the like SV-98 is a one-shot kill to the head nonetheless, and the longest like marksman headshot I got in the alpha trial was 237 meters, so plus 237, not too bad. But the engineer like rockets now, whenever you shoot them down tunnels and stuff like that, there's a light that comes behind them, and they kind of like light up the entire like tunnel or the subway system, which is the second area. I thought that was a pretty cool feature. Also, the sounds now of the game, depending on where you're at, if you're outside, your gun will sound different compared to if you were like inside, compared to if you're inside a smaller room, I guess, then it sounds different than to a bigger room, you know? So it makes it wherever you can probably actually tell where gunshots are coming from a lot easier too. It's just not the same old gun sound from everywhere, so they're making it a lot more realistic. The environments are quite destructible. You can make craters inside of the ground and then hide inside of them. Now you do have to hold your breath with the sniper now, and it's only for about a 5-second period that it gives you, but you can instantly re-hold your breath in the like alpha trial. So, but I think I'm probably gonna have to make this Battlefield 3 info trial, or yeah, commentary, a two-parter, because we're about running out. We only got about a minute left, so I'll talk about just a few more things. The assault class can now revive people, and you still do have the defibrillators. You just got to pretty much like rub them together like they do in the movies, you know. They like rub the two paddles together, and then they like shoot the dude with it, or like shock the dude with it. You got to do that like now to actually revive people, on top of you just don't revive the people. The people have to accept the revive or decline it. So if the person doesn't want to be Rambo revived, he's not going to be Rambo like revived, and you're not going to get any points for reviving that person, you know. But if he wants to be like revived, then he can just click a button, which was the space bar, I think, and you get like revived up. Pretty nice. You also eventually get the like health kits, and those reach for quite a long range. And I will definitely have to make this a two-parter anyways, guys. I hope you guys enjoying Team Fortress 2 gameplay. Be sure to like, comment, favorite, and subscribe my channel, and I'll be out with part 2 of this pretty soon. Take it easy, guys. Later.